to start from over on the mat. So we both basically have the same thing, just like on the feet. I have one arm under and one arm over. Right? So now his goal is to put me on my back and get past my legs, right? So you want to put me down,
make it past.
I'm trying to maintain this control or get to a better position of control and use this as you. So you don't have to stay in this position. You can transition to any other position, right? You don't know any other positions and try to stay here as long as you can, but this position gives you attacks on both sides. So to sweep the person, a couple of things have to happen. I need to bring his weight forward off of his heels, right? So as long as he's down, if you feel your partner sitting back like that, you're never going to be able to take him over. You have to get them to come forward a little bit so get their butt off of their heels. I need to block his arm and post him on the mat. So if I take him this way, I don't control his arm, he just posts him on the mat, he won't go over. So try to as much as you can keep him from being able to do that. So it's the same sweep in both directions. If I go to my right now, so I'm going to pull his butt off his heels. I'm going to keep control of his arm. I'm going to drop to my right shoulder. You see how I'm not going flat to my back. My right foot goes to the floor, and I lift to my left. I can use the same grip the other direction, right? So let's say I try to take him this way, he leans hard the other way, so he's not coming here. So I'm going to go overhook, trap the arm on this side, same idea, I fall to my shoulder, I don't go flat to my back, my left foot goes to the floor, take him over with my right foot. The other thing that can happen is, let's say right now, see how his head is right in my shoulder. Sometimes your partner's going to drop their head down like that. He buries his head comes below your shoulder, you'll be able to trap with a front headlock, and with this grip, you can take him in either direction. I prefer, if I ever get the front headlock, to take him over his head. Right? So I crunch his chin to his chest, same idea, I fall to my left shoulder, my left foot goes to the floor, and I lift my right leg. So what I want you guys to focus on is once you start here, is first keeping control of him, right? Then starting to manipulate his weight, right? And you're going to have to get a feel for where his weight is going. Right? So if I feel him drive this way, if I feel him driving this way, I'm just going to continue to take him that way. If I start to take him that way, he leans hard the other way, so he's not letting me go that way. I just switch, adjust my grip, and then take him back. So you want to develop a feel for wherever the weight is going. That's the direction you're going to take, and that can change as you're doing it, right? So I might start coming this way, he shifts the other way. I try to take him this way, he shifts back the other way. I can take my hand off his elbow, club his head, and take him back. If his head, he drops his weight real low and buries his head down, I can trap his neck and go right back to sweeping him over, all right? So, one more time. Start with the over under. Person on bottom, you're trying to control the person from this position and work to sweep them. Person on top, you're trying to keep your partner down, right? So if he breaks out, this is just being defensive and pulls away. So I want the person on bottom trying to come up. And remember, while you're here, this isn't like an upper body move. It's your legs that are going to do all the work. So you're constantly using your legs to off-balance your partner. If he steps up on a leg, my leg has to follow it. I can't let him step up. Right? And for right now, I want the person on top staying down on knees and pressuring in, trying to keep the person down and pass.